In the midst of Earth Week, Guam faces daunting environmental challenges. At the district court, the landfill receivership and waterworks stipulated order for violations of the Federal Clean Water Act are just the start. Today, Guam beholds an impending buildup that it can neither afford nor sustain.
US EPA came out and it kind of was a wake-up call to the island that there are some major concerns with the DIS and the buildup as proposed and DOD's plans for the buildup. Specifically, US EPA predicts up to a 13.1 million gallon per day shortage of water. Okay, if that happens and the wastewater treatment plants aren't taken care of, we're talking about raw sewage contaminating our drinking water.
So serious are the environmental concerns that President Obama sent highest level environmental staff to see things for themselves in March. Chair of the White House Council on Environmental Quality, Nancy Sutley, serves as the principal environmental policy advisor to the president.
We are committed to the principle of One Guam, where both civilian and military residents are served well. This visit is just one part of the work that the Obama administration is putting into assuring that the proposed buildup actions are done in an environmentally sound and sustainable way.
Yet the issues before Guam are not all buildup related. U.S. Administrator for Region 9, Gerald Blumenfeld, says even without the massive military buildup, Guam faces a lot of work ahead.
I think there's some real issues that need to be overcome in terms of how the infrastructure is improved just for the folks that are on island at the moment. So not even looking at the issues of the military buildup, we have some very serious concerns about the capacity of that infrastructure to serve the residents of Guam today.
Buildup or no buildup, Earth Week on Guam takes on new meaning, given the serious environmental problems now front line and center.